That day when I shared the reel of my kids making a greeting card, lots of people DM'd me and asked me that how are you getting your kids to write? Hence, in this video, I will be talking about how to get your kids interested in the art of writing. I did go ahead and ask a few kids why they don't like to write. So, the answer was plain and simple. Who writes? Do you write? I type. And I'm a pro at typing, so instead of writing, I will be typing. And in the future, in whatever office or whatever profession I am in, writing is not a part of that profession. Hence, why should I write? This was a plain and simple answer that three kids actually gave me. And I was actually dumbstruck, but I agreed with them. Even I don't write so much on a daily basis. It's a different thing that I maintain a journal, I write down my daily tasks, small tasks, big tasks and stuff like that. But my light writing is only limited to that. Hence, this brings me to the first point of making your kid understand why writing is important. Now, how to make sure that your kid gets interested in writing? First of all, logical reasoning is the most important thing that works with kids. So I sat down and explained to my kids why writing is really important. Now, initially I was laughing because, you know, I also did not like to write when I was a kid. But I made them understand that if you don't write in a particular language, you will not be able to master that language. Only reading that language is not enough. You have to be able to write in that language to be able to form sentences, to be able to have a good vocabulary of that particular language. In this case, I am referring to English. For example, if I did not know how to write, also reading becomes very, very, very difficult for me. And I have had a few friends who have learned Japanese. Now, Japanese, just like the Devanagari script, is a particularly different script. So, what those guys did is that they practiced one letter. I don't know how Japanese is read or written. For example, A. They practiced writing that A for months and months. And this is how they started writing each and every letter so that they could learn and eventually master the language. I gave this example to my kids and they were convinced. Hence, they started taking interest in writing. Now, this logical reasoning was able to make Reni understand. But what about Shiny? She doesn't know Japanese, she doesn't know Devanagari script or English alphabets, what they all are. So I just let it be. She did not want to write and I did not force her. I one day was, you know, just surfing through some channels and she liked Peppa Pig. So I let her watch Peppa Pig on YouTube, on TV, and she started getting interested in the world of Peppa Pig. Now, one fine day, what happened is when Peppa Pig book series launched in India, it was sent to us as a part of the Soup Mom Mithali Instagram team. And this is when the magic started happening. She wanted to read those books, you know, because it was her favorite character. She had seen it on TV and she couldn't read and she was so disappointed. And she told me that, Mama, I want to start reading. I want to start writing. And she said that all on her own. Also, when she started going to school, that really, really helped because everybody in the school was writing. They were practicing their A's, the capitals, the smalls. And this made her genuinely take interest in writing. But I would like to thank Peppa Pig for making my daughter interested in writing as well. Now, how to get smaller kids to be able to write, or, you know, to get them interested in writing? Smaller, I mean, you know, anyone from 3 to 5 years old, how to get them to write? So like what I was explaining in my reel, they let them just scribble, give them a piece of paper, give them a bit of crayons and let them just scribble away. And this sparks their imagination that at least they can hold the pen and pencil and the paper in their hand and they can scribble something. This will give them confidence that they, if they want to write something, can write. Here in this case, when you're dealing with smaller kids, do not force them to write, like, you know, you have to write A today, you have to write B today, you have to write C today, forcing or punishing them or, you know, shouting at them will again get negative emotions associated with that particular act of writing. Hence, they will never be able to write. So, only use positive things. If your kid refuses to write, just let them be. Eventually, they will start writing. This is with smaller kids. Now, when older kids like Renny's age, for example, 6 to 9 to 10 years are not able to write, this is not actually a good thing. This is a sign that, you know, something is missing. So maybe you should consult a psychologist and get them tested for ADHD and other things. I'm not saying this in a very derogatory or a negative manner. These are some things that we need to understand and consider as parents. If our kid is lacking in something, then we need to give them that extra support so that they are able to cope up with the world. So all these things like ADHD and all are detrimental to kids' progress. Hence, getting it checked and just crossing it off the chart is a good idea. Now, second way in which your kid, if he or she is just refusing to write, it's because of sheer boredom or lack of any motivation, then here is what you can do. Now, identify something which your kid is absolutely interested in. Okay, for example, Renny is really interested in science fiction and what the outside world looks like, and, you know, what if we are not on Earth and we are on Mars, and what if we are in a completely different realm. So I use that particular thing to spark her imagination. Now, what I ask her to do is, I ask her to write these things down. For example, how extraterrestrial life would be, or how a life would be on a different planet. Now, she absolutely loves these things, so she goes ahead and starts writing these things. So, this is how you can ask your kid to write. If you have a boy and he is interested in particular sport, like a football or stuff like that, then you can ask him or her to write about football or whatever he loves, and that way your kid will start writing. Immediately, don't start pointing out their mistakes, that this is the way you write and this is your handwriting and this is what you will do. Just encourage them, thank them that they have started writing, and this is just the beginning of the more exciting journey in the world of writing. Now, if by writing, if you are meaning homework, then nobody likes to do homework. I will tell you about myself. I never did homework from first to my last year, from first standard to TY. And I confidently told them that mera sab homework ho gaya hai, and nobody ever even punished me. So when my older daughter's school called me and said that, you know, she is not doing any homework, I told them that I have never done any homework and I do not believe in the concept of homework, and they all were a little worried as to what kind of a mother is she. So the reason why I do not believe in homework is because I believe in extracurricular activities. Now when my daughter comes home at 6:30 in the evening and she has been out since the morning 9 o'clock, I cannot expect her to come home and study again and write something. Hence, I do not believe in homework. And I have made it clear to the school that, you know, my kids, even if they don't do homework, it's okay. It's school is about learning, it's about enjoying. Hence, I don't know what you guys believe in, but I absolutely do not believe in homework. But this does not mean that your kids should not write, or, you know, their workbook should remain incomplete. Now, what I do is, all this homework for both my kids is mostly sorted out during the weekends. Now, whatever homework they get during the weekdays, if they want to, they do it themselves at night, you know, just before sleeping, or, you know, just when they feel like doing it, because they love and enjoy doing the same. On weekends, I sit with them, I plan their work, and I see what kind of homework have they been assigned, and sometimes I even let that go. This makes them responsible for their own studies, for their own writing, for their own homework, and they in turn like doing it. So, reverse psychology. Many times as a parent, you have to apply reverse psychology for your kids to get interested in a particular subject. For me, this reverse psychology of homework really works, because, you know, then they are left with no answers to just tell their teachers or, you know, tuition teacher or whatever it is. Hence, they end up doing it themselves and I am spared. So, did this video make sense? How did you like this video of how to get your kids interested in writing? Generally, sitting down with them and explaining them really makes sense. This is the most simple technique, and apart from that, you can use other techniques which are specified by me in the video. So, how did you like the video? Let me know in the comment section below. Share it with a lot of your friends. I'm sure this is the most important and common concern that lots of mothers of kids in this generation are facing. Hence, it will solve a lot of problems for them. I have given some practical advice here as well. Subscribe to our channel because that will make sure that I keep on making these videos week after week and present it to you. And thank you so much for watching this video. Keep on rocking. Bye.